Bharti Airtel in 2017 agreed to merge with Millicom's Tigo in Ghana to become the country's second largest mobile operator, Airtel Tigo. The National Communications Authority granted approval for merging the two companies to combine their operations. Airtel Tigo serves around 5.1 million subscribers and offers employment opportunities to almost 10,000 people, both directly and indirectly. In October 2020, Airtel and Millicom announced that they were exiting the Ghanaian market, and this agreement concludes the extensive negotiations between the parties to ensure a seamless transition and continued operations of Airtel Tigo thereafter.
Key among them was a $100 million facility from Standard Chartered, Standard Bank. And that is also the Airtel and Tigo have taken 50% of that facility. So the company is only now saddled with 50% of that liability. These measures also help free the company from the debt burden that it was under.
This agreement transfers all customers, assets, and agreed liabilities of Airtel Tigo to the government of Ghana. With the exit of the telecom operations, the Ghanaian government, through the Minister for Communications, has assured all stakeholders that their interests will be protected.
We will use this opportunity to assure all local creditors of the company that we're going to sit down with them and look at ways in which we can assist the company to meet its obligations towards them, because all those businesses have to also thrive and succeed, and that includes anybody that the company may be indebted to us at this stage. It is still working, so this is not the time for any subscriber to move away from that company.
She again stressed that no single company will be made to monopolize the telecom space.
Any of these companies can also provide high-speed data and voice connectivity using their existing spectrum. Now, when we talk about infrastructure sharing as well, it means that all the assets that you have, if you have excess capacity, you can lease that capacity to your competitor so that you get additional income and your competitor can also ride on your infrastructure to deliver the services. And we hope that that will stimulate greater competition in this sector, reduce the upfront capital expenditure costs, and make it easier for the ultimate beneficiary, the consumer, to get excellent or better service from all the companies that are currently working in this country. So we believe that with a mix of all these measures, the reduced debt burden on Airtel Tigo, that company very soon would also be out of the difficulties that have led its former shareholders to decide to walk away from Ghana.
The telecommunications sector, according to the minister, is of strategic importance to government, and it will ensure that the sector remains vibrant and competitive in order to make Ghana the digital hub of the sub-region.